But I really would like you to memorize this line. Yani, I wish I can translate it into English properly and precisely. أهل السنة والجماعة يستدلون ثم يعتقدون. Shall I say this again? Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, they seek the evidence, the burhan, the dalil, then they formulate beliefs and actions. So first they look for what? Evidence. So they build up the evidence, and on the basis of the evidence, they say we believe in them. We can do that. We cannot do that. Look to the contrary. العكس, the opposite. وأهل الهوى, the people who follow their desire, the people who follow their whims, أهل البدع, they do the opposite exactly. يعتقدون ثم يستدلون. So they build up a certain belief on false, or let's be polite, on unfounded evidence, no foundation, and then they look for an evidence. Where is the evidence for that? القواعد الأربع لإثبات العقائد والأحكام الشرعية. There are five foundations. أهل السنة والجماعة follow five steps. They follow in order to establish beliefs and actions. A short introduction. قال تعالى وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whatever the messenger commands you to do, do, and whatever the messenger bans you from doing, do not do it. وقول النبي صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم فيما أخرج الإمام مسلم من حديث أم المؤمنين عائشة رضي الله عنها من أحدث في أمرنا هذا ما ليس منه فهو رد. Whoever introduces something into the religion that was not part of the religion, it will be rejected. وقول الإمام مالك رحمه الله كل يؤخذ منه ويرد إلا صاحب هذا القبر. الإمام مالك is the Imam of Dar al-Hijra in Medina. He says everyone, you can say no to him. Every sheikh, every imam, every scholar, anybody, you can tell him, no, this is wrong. Except who? The one who was buried in this grave. وقال أيضا, and he said, رحمه الله, ما لم يكن يومئذ دينا فلا يكون اليوم دينا. If it was not a religion at the time of the Prophet and his companions, then it shouldn't be what? Deen now. Something that is new, it should not be there. طريق السلف يا إخوة, طريق الصحابة, طريق التابعين, of إثبات النصوص الشرعية, they follow the following four steps. Number one, you must provide an evidence from the Quran or the authentic hadith. That's step number one. That's step number one. Can you have an evidence just from the hadith? I'm asking you, can you? ممكن الدليل يكون فقط من الحديث؟ لا, ممكن. Yes, you can have just an evidence from the hadith. لأن الحديث وحي. Because the hadith what? Is a revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَأَنْزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الذِّكْرَ لِتُبَيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ. So number one, step number one what? You must provide an evidence for the subject you're asking me to believe in or you're asking me to do. مسألة تقول لي لابد أن أنت تعتقد هذا الشيء، إيه الدليل على اعتقاد؟ أعمل هذا الشيء، إيه هو الدليل؟ إيتيني بدليل. قرآن أو سنة. One. Two. Look at the second step here. You must compile all the evidence related to the subject matter. So there is a mention on the subject in Surah Al-Baqarah. You must bring the verses. In Surah Al-Imran, you must. So you must, in that hadith, you must compile what? All the evidence. And you place it together. So this is step number two. You cannot just take one evidence. You may reach the wrong what? Conclusion. Exactly, you will be what? Manipulating the text. You will be taking it what? Out of context. تخرج الدليل من سياقه. تخرج الدليل من إيه؟ من سياقه. I'll give you an example here. And this is why some of the people, some of the Egyptian Muslims, they came up with it. بعض المصريين عندنا جننوا. قالوا ليه اليهود والنصارى ما بيحجوش؟ Why the Jews and the Christians are not performing Hajj like the Muslims? And he provided the evidence. What is the evidence? وأذن في الناس بالحج يأتوك رجالا ولله. He actually provided two evidence. ولله على وقت الناس. In the Arabic language, if you place the article of definition, which is what in English? The, in Arabic what? If al joins a noun, that means what? كل الناس. العموم والشمول. جميع الناس. طب what did this person do? This person taken, he only took what? We have in Surah At-Tawbah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّمَا الْمُشْرِكُونَ نَجَسْ فَلَا يَقْرَبُوا الْمَسْجِدَ الْحَرَامَ بَعْدَ عَامِهِمْ هَذَا. Oh, you believe indeed the polytheists are impure. نجاسة الروح والقلب عشان الشرك. So they should not come near what? المسجد الحرام. What this person, that's why we say what? We say what? You have to do what? You have to compile all the evidence. And this is why anybody who comes up with a weird verdict in Islam now, he is taking it out of context. He's not compiling what? وده فن البحث ولا إيه اللي بندرسه في بتدرسوه في this is the art of what? Of research. That's ABC research. ABC research. And I tell you, sometimes you can take a verse from the Quran out of a context of a hadith. The famous verse Fox News repeats all the time. اقتلوا المشركين حيث وجدتموهم. عندنا Fox News هنا في أمريكا شغالة على الآية دي يعني شهرتها. Made it famous. Kill the infidels where you find it. This verse is taken out of context exactly because there is hadith fi Sunan al-Nasa'i regarding the story behind this verse that tells you this particular command has to do with the time being, not something that is what to be extended what beyond that, because this was special circumstances and we don't have time to get to that, but this is in brief, taking things out of context. So what's step number one here? We said four. Step number one? Evidence. One evidence. Two, compile all the evidence. Number three, you must establish the authenticity of the evidence. Number three, you must establish. Who said that this hadith is authentic? Of course, the Quran is all what? Authentic. But now, regarding the hadith, who said? A lot of the people who come up with these weird fatwas in Islam, they bring about what? ويك أحاديث، أحاديث ضعيفة، أحاديث منكرة، أحاديث موضوعة، يبقى لابد أن تذكر من صحح هذا الحديث. في تلميذ حديث البخاري ومسلم نأخذه ويتيكل، بط في تلميذ الترمذي، النسائي، أبي داود، مسند الإمام أحمد، ابن ماجة، ابن حبان، مصنف عبد الرزاق، أبو يعلى الموصلي، all of these, all of these. You must provide the authority of an expert of a hadith who said this hadith is what? Is authentic. So this is number three. Number four, which is the most difficult, and it really takes a scholar, is sorting out the evidence. Because sometimes there is a general evidence and there is what? Private. عام خاص. There is unrestricted, exactly like the one who steals. What are we supposed to do with him? Cut off the hand. You know what the hand means in Arabic? اليد. هذه اليد. Right here. So هذا إيه مطلق. So from where is it? Where? The hadith explains. From where? And also the hadith explains how much and the criteria to prove that this person is guilty of theft before you even go and do that. You must sort out what, ya ikhwa? You must sort out the, also there are things that abrogated in Islam. Particular ahkam that got what? اللي هو الناسخ والإيه؟ والمنسوخ. You have an evidence that cancelled out what? An existing evidence. So you must be able to understand all of this. So these are, ya ikhwa, the four rules which a person must follow in Islam in order to establish. Let's apply this to practical time now. Four. We said number one is what? Provide the evidence. Number two, compile all of them. Number three, establish the authenticity of the evidence if it is a sunnah. Number four, establish the fact that this is what it means by going through these multiple evidence on the same subject to sort out the general from the private, the restricted from the unrestricted, the abrogated from the abrogating. You understand? طيب, let's be practical here in closing. Next Tuesday, the Muslims across the globe are going to celebrate the birthday of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يوم الثلاثة اللي جاي بيقول لك في احتفال مولد النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Can you provide one of these? Can you provide give three, four of these? Provide one evidence that this happened. Provide one evidence. ما يوجد. No Quran, no Sunnah, no Ijma. And we're going to come next time to what is the evidence? The Quran, we're going to go through it. The agreed upon evidence and the disputed evidence. None. There is no reference whatsoever in the Quran, in the Sunnah, in the practice of the Sahaba that none of them. There is a piece of document that. Circulating on social media, which I loved reading it. I don't know if you came across it with the four questions. Yeah, what are these questions? Can you please tell me? The first question is, this is a quiz regarding celebrating the birthday of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so that you show that you love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, السؤال الأول, كم مرة احتفل رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بميلاده? How many times did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam celebrate his birthday? This is the first question. Tell me, Saadi. The next question. Look at the next one. How many times did the Sahaba celebrate the birthday of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Tell me. What is the other questions?
Oh, I can't find.
Yeah, it's fine. Look at this. Is it true that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was born on the 12th of ربيع الأول؟ فعلا صح أن النبي ولد يوم 12 ربيع الأول؟ أنت عارف كده ولا اتولد يوم 12 ربيع الأول؟ أنت عارف سبحان الله أتدري شيء؟ كل ما نعرفه عن ميلاده صلى الله عليه وسلم عام الفيل يوم الاثنين بس، ما عندنا شيء تاني خالص. بل هناك من العلماء، there are some of the scholars who said he was born in Ramadan. عام الفيل برضو on a Monday. There are others who said in شعبان. And of course there are said who said in... طيب، فهذا هو يا إخوة، هذا هو الدين. This is the deen الذي جاء به رسولنا صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is the religion of Islam. And how we establish it and how we base it. And how we move with it. But this heresy and made up things in the religion. سبحان ربي. سبحان ربي. عايزين يأكلوا حلاوة. الحلاوة دي في مصر بس، حلاوة المولد. كلها في حلاوة. عندنا مصر عروسة المولد. احنا عندنا احنا عروسة المولد وحصان المولد. فاكر حصان المولد وجمل المولد. The horse of the مولد. In Egypt and the camel of the مولد. سبحان الله. فنسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يثبتنا على الحق وأن يهدينا صراطا مستقيما وأن يجعلنا من هؤلاء الذين يظهرون حبهم لنبيهم باتباع صلى الله عليه وسلم. قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله. جزاكم الله خيرا. We'll continue إن شاء الله with the الفقه. But again, we're going to build up a little bit, inshallah, to you're going to enjoy the algorithm that I'm going to follow, inshallah. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك، والحمد لله رب العالمين.